you wish, you will, nothing else but life, not death. And so when you do exactly that, you also expect to be ridiculed like Jesus. So stand up and say, Christ is risen from the dead. They ridicule you. Stand up and say, abortion will be ended. It must be ended. It can be ended. When you do that, they will ridicule you. Stand up and say that the child, even this big still, dun sa sinapupunan ng kanyang nanay, and then say, this is already a living human soul, a human person, therefore, that must be valued. If you stand up and say that, they ridicule you. Stand up and say that no human government has the authority to authorize the killing of the innocent. No parent, no mother, no doctor, nobody has the authority to choose death for the baby. When you do that, they ridicule you. Stand up and say that no human government has the authority to allow or to authorize extrajudicial killing of suspected drug users. Stand up and say that, they ridicule you. You will be surrounded by trolls. Stand up and say that is not the way of Jesus to curse, to say, put more. You stand up and say that, they will ridicule you. Stand up and say that it is not the way of Jesus to threaten life. Papatayin kita. Papatayin kayong lahat. Stand up and say and resist that, they ridicule you. Stand up and say that it is, you know, that it is not the way of Jesus to be passing judgment, saying condemnatory remarks, spreading fake news, false information, spreading chismes about other people. It is killing other people in their social life. And if you stand up and say that, they ridicule you. I'm sure there are a long list that we can make, and each one of us have our own experiences of what that means to follow Jesus in this way in order to protect life. Each one of us. It's just because we are Catholic Christians, surely that is the way to follow Jesus, to stand up for life. But even if they ridicule you, just deep in your heart, you will be right. Because you will be on the side of God Himself, in Jesus Christ, who has destroyed death and restored life. And the bright side now of following Jesus in His way of life is that you yourself, everywhere you go, you will feel light, and you will feel more life within you. Because that is precisely what Jesus came to earth and lived our human life with us, when He said, I have come in order that they may have life and have it abundantly and have it to the full. So, brothers and sisters, let us rejoice today over these scriptural readings that we have heard, proclaiming to us, God is not the maker of death. God has given us life, and He wants us to live it to its fullness. God loves life in its own us. And so when we receive Jesus here in Holy Communion, remember, again, whom we say He is the way, He is the truth, and the life. And when you have Jesus with you, within you, who is living